Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Shake Hand with Life. I am Narinder Sharma. In this video, we are going to understand another application of chi-square test as a test of independence, as a non-parametric test. So if there is an experiment is designed to test the effectiveness of a vaccine against a viral infection like coronavirus attack, then how would you conclude that the vaccine is effective to prevent the spread of the infection? Here, the chi-square test as a test of independence is really impressive. So in this video, we'll understand the use of chi-square test as a test of independence, also known as the test of association. But before we make a move in this video, make sure that you have subscribed Shake Hand with Life YouTube channel and hit the bell to get notified about my latest video lectures. Okay, let's start it now. Here is the data of an experiment based on vaccination of people attacked by a viral infection. So in cell 1, the number of people vaccinated who are infected also is 31. In cell 2, the number of people vaccinated who are not infected is 469. In cell 3, the people who are not vaccinated but infected are 185. And in cell 4, people who are not vaccinated and also not infected are 1315. So on the basis of this data available, we have to conclude that the vaccine is effective to prevent the infection at 5% significance level. So here we proceed to solve this problem. First, we have to state the null and alternative hypothesis. For the test of independence, we have to conclude that there is no association between vaccination and the infection. It means the vaccine is not effective to prevent the infection to spread. Hence, the null hypothesis assumed as H0 such that vaccination is not effective. And the alternative hypothesis is assumed as HA such that vaccination is effective. It implies the vaccination and the infection not independent but associated, and the vaccination is effective to prevent the spread of the infection. Now from the observed data recorded from the experiment, the frequency of vaccinated in row 1 is 31 plus 469 equal to 500. And the frequency of not vaccinated in row 2 is 185 plus 1315 equal to 1500. And the frequency of infected in column 1 is 31 plus 185 equal to 216. And the frequency of not infected in column 2 is 469 plus 1315 equal to 1784. Now the total frequency of vaccinated and not vaccinated is 500 plus 1500 equal to 2000, and similarly the total frequency of infected and not infected is 216 plus 1784 equal to 2000. Hence the total frequency N is 2000 here. Now we calculate the expected frequencies in all four cells. So the expected frequency of cell 1 is the frequency of vaccinated 500 multiplied to the frequency of infected people which is 216 divided by the total frequency, which is 2000, and this will be 54. Now the expected frequency of cell 2 is the frequency of vaccinated, which is 500 multiplied to the frequency of not infected, which is 1784 divided by 2000, and we get 446. Now the expected frequency of cell 3 is the frequency of not vaccinated, which is 1500 multiplied to the frequency of infected, which is 216 divided by 2000, and we get 162. Now the expected frequency of cell 4 is the frequency of not vaccinated, which is 1500 multiplied to the frequency of not infected, which is 1784 divided by 2000, and we get 1338. Now rearrange the observed frequencies and expected frequencies in table format. Column number 1 is 4 cell numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4, and the corresponding observed frequencies in cell 1, 2, 3, 4 are 31, 469, 185 and 1315 taken in column number 2. And the corresponding expected frequencies in cell 1, 2, 3, 4 are 54, 446, 162 and 1338 taken in column number 3. Now in column number 4, find the differences of the observed frequencies and the expected frequencies. So here in corresponding to cell number 1, 31 minus 54 equal to minus 23. And for cell number 2, it is 469 minus 446 equal to 23. For cell number 3, it is 185 minus 162 equal to 23. And for cell number 4, it is 1315 minus 1338 equal to minus 23. Now in column number 5, find the square of the differences of the observed frequencies and expected frequencies. So square of minus 23 equal to 529. Similarly, square of 23 also equal to 529. Square of 23 equal to 529 for cell number 3, and square of minus 23 equal to 529 for cell number 4. And in column number 6, divide the square of the differences of observed frequencies and expected frequencies by the expected frequencies. So here we have, for cell number 1, it is 529 divided by 54, and we get 9.796. For cell number 2, it is 529 divided by 446, and we get 1.186. And for cell number 3, it is 529 divided by 162, and we get 3.265. And for cell number 4, it is 529 divided by 1338, and we get 0.395. And finally, we find the value of chi-square by adding the values in column number 6 corresponding to cell 1, 2, 3 and 4. And here we get chi-square equal to sigma of square of the differences of observed frequencies and expected frequencies divided by the expected frequencies equal to 9.796 plus 1.186 plus 3.265 plus 0.395, and we get 14.642, the value of chi square. So the null hypothesis assumed as the vaccine is not effective, and the alternative hypothesis assumed as the vaccine is effective against the spread of the infection. And our calculated value of chi-square is 14.642 that we have calculated from the observed frequencies and expected frequencies. The significance level is 5% here, or you can say that alpha equal to 0.05. It implies we are 95% confident to claim that the vaccine is not effective, but for 5% we are doubtful that we could make an error to claim that the vaccine is not effective against the infection, against the spread of the infection. The degrees of freedom will equal to number of rows minus 1 multiplied to number of columns minus 1. Here the number of rows are 2 and the number of columns are also 2. Hence the degrees of freedom equal to R minus 1 multiplied to C minus 1 equal to 2 minus 1 multiplied to 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Now refer the chi-square distribution table and mark the value under 0.05 for 1 degrees of freedom, and it is 3.841. It is the critical value of chi-square at 5% significance level. Now compare the calculated value of chi-square with the critical value of chi-square, and we find that the calculated value of chi-square, which is 14.642, is much greater than the critical value of chi-square, which is 3.841. Now because the calculated value of chi-square is greater than the critical value of chi-square, hence we reject the null hypothesis, which we have assumed as the vaccine is not effective against the spread of the infection. And finally, we conclude that the vaccine is effective against the spread of the infection. And that's it. If you have any question or suggestions, then please do write your feedback in the comment box below. Hit the like button and share this video with your friends and colleagues. Switch to Shake Hand with Life YouTube channel for more videos. Subscribe the channel and hit the bell to get the notifications of my latest video lectures. Visit on shakehandwithlife.in to download the course notes and ebooks in PDF. See you soon in my next video.